The versions and history in a document captures every design change made by the entire team. However, when there are thousands of entries, it can be difficult to find the exact change you're looking for. To make this process easier, a new search bar has been added. So, if you want to find the last time the document was restored, or you want to see which branches have been merged, you can simply type in a search term and all the relevant entries will be shown. A text search will find all entries in all branches. Adding more terms will find entries that include any of the keywords. If you want to find entries that match the entire search term, place each keyword in quotes. While this helps you to filter the history, the advanced search takes it one step further. Here, you can filter by individual element tab. This list is alphabetical, starting with part studios, then assemblies, then drawings. Alternatively, you can filter by element type. The modified by filter gives you the options of only me, not me, and any. And you can filter by start date and end date. Clicking on the date picker allows you to choose a date, and if you're using Chrome, a time as well. Firefox and Safari do not have a time picker, but you can type the time in if needed. Combining the date range, who modified it, and a specific tab shows you who worked on the project, what they did, and for roughly how long they spent doing it. Clicking on the history entry will take you to that moment in time in the document. Then you can create a version or restore it. To see exactly where you are in the document and in which branch, clearing the search field will show the full versions and history graph. Scrolling through endless lists of changes is now history. Onshape part properties now include a value for mass, which is computed based on the assigned material. The units are the same as the workspace, and this value can be overridden if required, for example, when using imported supplier parts. This value for mass can then be used wherever the part is used, such as an assembly bill of materials. Changing the part material will of course recalculate the mass and update it everywhere. In drawings, the mass can be displayed in a BOM table or in a note or title block on a part drawing. The Create Selection tool is now fully integrated into the context menu. Hovering over a face or an edge and then right-clicking will filter the selection options. So, for a face, you can select pocket faces. Since the seed for loop chain of connected edges is a face, this option is also shown here. You can then use this new selection method to build your geometry selections before creating a feature. For example, all these spline edges need to be filleted, so by selecting the appropriate geometry options, the amount of time making manual selections is greatly reduced. When creating variable fillets, you can control the radius at every vertex along the chain of edges. But if there are no vertices, you have to start splitting faces to create them. Now, you can simply select an edge and either drag the manipulator to position the inflection point or type in the exact position as a percentage of the selected edge length. There's no limit to the number of points you can add, and with it being much easier to position the point, you can get the exact result you require. Onshape continues to enhance existing features to streamline the modeling workflow. The split part feature now gives you the option to keep both sides of the split, which is the default as before, or choose which side to keep. This reduces the amount of clutter in your models, so there's no need to use a delete part feature, and it helps to convey your design intent.
When designing products that require smooth flowing surfaces, curvature visualization, also known as zebra stripes, is an essential tool to investigate tangency and curvature continuity between surfaces, as well as ripples and other imperfections. Additional controls have now been added to change the spacing and direction of the stripes, to help you inspect the quality of your surfaces in finer detail. Onshape automatically selects the best level of detail to balance the appearance of a model and performance. However, there are times when you need to override these settings to get an high quality representation for detailed surface analysis. If you're working with multiple surfaces, this can be time consuming, especially if you want to set it back to automatic afterwards. Now, whenever you need a better graphics representation, you can simply switch your view to high quality on demand and only for the time needed to finish the job. The Show Curvature command is now able to display curvature comps on faces to help you visualize the quality of your surfaces. This can also be used during feature creation. Using the Extend Across Face option, continues the curvature comps onto the faces connected to your feature, so you can easily check for continuity. In both top-down and bottom-up design, parts sometimes need to be edited in context to help the designer reference geometry from other parts in the assembly. Editing in context shows all the other assembly instances in a ghosted transparency that makes them virtually invisible and difficult to select their faces or edges. A new context transparency slider now makes it easy to adjust the visibility on these items and hide them completely if needed. When working in complex part studios or large assemblies, using the isolate command is a great way to focus your attention on particular areas. Sometimes, however, the number of ghosted parts on screen can be a distraction, so the isolate command now includes a new option to hide ghosted parts completely. The filter at the top of a feature list can be used to understand how a part, surface or curve was built. However, this requires you to type in the name of a part, and if there are multiple parts with the same name, the features you are looking for can be difficult to identify. Now, you can select one or more items from the part list, and their features are cross-highlighted in the feature list, making it faster and easier to get a better understanding of the design history.
Adding radius dimensions to parts that have a lot of draft, for example, can be a challenge, because an arc is often not a true arc, but an ellipse or spline. Silhouette edges are fine, because they can be projected as a true arc, but edges that are not normal to the view direction are not. You can't create an auxiliary view for every fillet, so it's common practice to create a true dimension that tells the viewer what size radius has been applied to an edge. Onshape is now able, using the radial dimension tool, to measure the radius of the face that the edge has been created from and add a radius dimension as required. This is a true dimension, so changes to the design will update the radius dimension as you would expect. In addition to the built-in computed mask property, Onshape Professional and Enterprise customers can now create their own custom computed part properties. For example, volume and shipping size, which estimates packaging based on the size of the part. Let's have a look at how these are set up. First, you need to import a new module, computed part property, and at least common. Then create an annotation with property function name so that Onshape knows it's a computed part property. The define computed part property function returns a value that must be a value with units, string, boolean, or number. In this case, because we are calculating volume, it returns a value with units, and the calculation is pretty simple. For the shipping size function, we need to return a string. Then all we're doing is calculating the bounding box, getting the individual dimensions of the box, then if it falls below a certain size, it's small, above, it's large, and otherwise medium. Finally, we want to add a function that calculates the cost of the sheet material required to manufacture a part. First, we're getting the flattened part definition, then the bounding box, then calculating the maximum size of sheet that is needed to fully enclose the flattened part. This is in no way optimized, it's just an example. Because the part is fully regenerated before these functions are called, we are able to use get property to interrogate other part properties and use them in our calculations. Finally, a map for sheet cost per kilo and a return string for cost. Now, to get the function to work, the company administrator needs to create or modify an existing custom property. The type must be the same as the return type of the function, in this case, text. Turn on Editing Workspace if you want your users to be able to override this value. Then you need to set the category to Part. Only once you have done that will the Computed Part Properties section appear, since these functions only work with parts. Now you can navigate and choose the function to use. Back in the Part Studio, we can now see the part properties include the new computed value for sheet cost, which is based on the size of the flat pattern. Changing the material will regenerate the part and trigger the computed part property functions for mass, volume, shipping size, and sheet cost.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.